U.S. stocks, they moved between small gains and losses during a choppy trading session Wednesday after the major averages posted their fourth straight rally. Now first on the U.S. economic front, wholesale inventories, they declined 0.5% in May, falling by the most in over 1 year and a half, with economists forecasting inventories to rise 0.3%. And weekly mortgage applications, they dropped last week as the surge in interest rates pushed borrowing costs to their highest level in 2 years. Meanwhile, after the FOMC minutes, Fed Chairman Ben Bernanke is scheduled to speak right after the bell on the topic, the first 100 years, a century of U.S. central banking, goals, frameworks, accountability. Investors will closely watch for hints as to when the central bank will pare back its bond buying program. Meanwhile, overseas in China, the Shanghai Composite rallied after dismal reports data for June lifted hopes that the People's Bank of China could ease monetary policy in order to boost growth. And over in Europe, the euro recovered after tumbling to a three-month low against the dollar following Italy's downgrade by credit ratings agency S&P on Tuesday. Keeping focus in the forex markets, the dollar fell to three-day lows against the yen on Wednesday after cheap Chinese trade data for June lifted concerns about the outlook for global growth and lifting safe haven demand for the yen. Taking a look now to see how the Dow Jones has performed on this, the 10th of July, 2013. The Dow Jones Industrial Average for the most part was in negative territory, led by American Express, with the index trading within a narrow 70-point range throughout the afternoon. The S&P 500 and the Nasdaq continued to trade within a narrow range as well, and the volatility index that traded above 14. In earnings news today, Family Dollar soared after the retailer edged past earnings expectations and raised its outlook for the year. On the downside, Neighbors Industries, that fell to lead the S&P 500 laggards after the oil services provider said its second quarter profit would fall short of Wall Street expectations. Hewlett Packard, meanwhile, rallying after Citigroup upgraded its rating on the tech giant to buy from sell, pointing to increasing benefits from cost savings in the second half of the year. Apple edged lower after a federal judge ruled that the iPhone maker conspired to raise the retail prices of e-books and said a trial for damages will follow.